following program is a MCTV Midland Community Television production. Stand by in studio, stand by to roll one, and fade up on one, and roll music. Stand by title and title. Stand by to lose title, stand by to lose music, stand by to mic and cue. In 4, 3, 2, lose title, lose music, mic and cue.
Hello, and welcome to our very first program, produced by Midland Community Television. Tonight we'll take a look at some examples of programs that can be done right here in the MCTV studio and on location with MCTV equipment. Stage Door Productions, a junior achievement company, shows the basic interview format. Steve Lorla will give us a look at the latest exhibit on the mezzanine gallery at the library. We'll go back to Halloween and see some preschoolers trick-or-treating at the library. Then we'll learn a little about the Silver Stick hockey tournament that was held earlier this month. But first, let me tell you more about MCTV and how you can get involved. MCTV is Midland Community Television, and Midland Community Television is just that, community television. MCTV was established for basically two reasons. One, to allow you, the community, the opportunity to use the television medium to communicate, educate, inform, and entertain. The second reason was to provide Midland with locally produced programs of public interest. Some of the programs will be produced by the city of Midland itself. The other programs will come from you. Let's take a look at a videotape that was done right here in the MCTV studio. This videotape was produced by Stage Door Productions, a junior achievement company. These high school students operate the equipment as well as doing the interviewing. Let's take a look. Steve, roll tape.
Hello, my name is Scott Barnes and I'm here for the JA Television Company, Stage Door Productions. Today with me is Tanya Dalton from Australia.
G'day.
She is a Youth for Understanding foreign exchange student which is previously attending Dow High School. Tanya, what actually is Youth for Understanding?
Youth for Understanding is a worldwide corporation that started in America, and it gives kids from all around the world a chance to go overseas and experience different cultures.
That's neat. How did you decide to become an exchange student?
My cousin was a Rotary exchange student to Japan, and she was probably my big inspiration. She went, so of course I wanted to go too.
What are some of the differences between your home country and the United States?
There's so many, but the main ones for me would be things like you drive on the right-hand side of the road, we drive on the left-hand side of the road, and the weather. In Australia, where I live, I don't have snow. I've never seen snow. And then I came to Michigan, and it really shocked me, first of all. They were the main.
You mean you guys drive on the opposite side of the road?
We have our steering wheels on the right-hand side of the car, but we drive on the left-hand side of the road.
Is there anything that you had trouble adjusting to?
I'd have to say the weather. The snow was just so overwhelming. I couldn't get used to it because in Australia, the coldest weather I'd experienced was about 52 Fahrenheit.
Are American schools very different to those of your homeland, and if so, what things are different?
Yes, they are a lot different. We have 8 lessons a day, and they're all in different order. Every day of the week, they're in a different order. And we have 40-minute lessons, not 55-minute. And we have a 20-minute recess and also a 40-minute lunch, so we get more breaks.
But isn't that kind of confusing?
Not really. First lesson. If you really hate your first lesson on a Monday, well, on the Tuesday, you might have a lesson that you really like. So it breaks up the week more.
That's a nice idea. What do you miss most from your home country?
Oh, the Australian beaches and Vegemite.
Vegemite?
I don't know if you've heard that song from Men at Work, but they say about a Vegemite sandwich. Vegemite's a spread. We put it on our bread just like you put it on peanut butter on toast. And it's pitch black and it's made of yeast extract. Made of yeast extract.
Okay. Do you celebrate the same public holidays as we do in the United States, such as Christmas, Thanksgiving?
We do have Christmas and Easter, but then we have other holidays. You have the 4th of July, we have Australia Day. We also, instead of Memorial Day, we have Anzac Day, which is quite similar. And then we have Labor Day, like you do.
Thank you, Tanya. And for Stage Door Productions, I'm Scott Barnes. Good night.
Now let's take a look at another videotape they did that took a little bit more time because it was shot on location. They took the portable recorder and the camera, and this is what they did.
Last October, we visited the Midland Center for the Arts where the production Annie was being performed. We went backstage and interviewed a few of the main characters in the production and also Mr. Dick Ryan, the artistic director of the Music Society. Can you tell us about the people involved in Annie?
Sure, I'd be glad to. There's a tremendous cross-section of people involved in a production like Annie. There are people who play in the orchestra pit, the kids on stage who dance and sing, people that build scenery, even people that sell tickets for us. It's amazing the number of people from all around the community that really find ways that they know that they can be of value to what goes on and find really good expressions for them being in the show, all in different ways. It's fun for all of them, I hope.
About the actors in this production, how does the acting ability of the children match up to the acting ability of the adults?
The children are just as good as the adults. It's amazing how well the kids have responded to it. Part of it is the fact that it's very well written for the kids. But the kids are very well trained, they're spontaneous, they have absolutely no inhibitions at all, and the kids are absolutely wonderful. They are equally as good as the adults, and we have some very good adult actors.
What is a typical year for a music society? What is offered in it?
The Music Society is a very large organization. We offer a whole offering of opportunities for performances that vary from musical comedy to pop events. For instance, in the summer festival when we bring in big name stars, we offer dance companies that come in, we offer Christmas concerts, the whole range of musical theater, anything that involves singing on stage with staging, any of those are the kinds of things the Music Society offers, and we need volunteer participants in every single end of it.
If one of our viewers would like to get involved in the Music Society, how would they go about doing that?
We always need more people to work with us. We have somewhere in the neighborhood of 2,000 people that work with us annually, and we could easily use many more. The thing to do is simply to call the Music Society office, and we'll take your name, and we have a whole procedure for dealing with people who are either new to the Music Society or new to town. You'll call, and we'll take down a little bit of information about you, and then call back and find out more about which part of your interest background would fit in with our organization and in what way. And we really want to welcome new people. We think it's one of the most important things we do to make sure that people feel welcome to our organization, just like they have to be welcome to the town if they're new here.
Do you have a phone number for that?
Thank you. Yes, I do. To call the Music Society office, you simply call 631-1072.
We're in the makeup room talking with Heather Neiman and Sarah Crooks, the two Annies of the production Annie. Sarah, what part of the play do you like the best?
The singing. Just getting to perform on the stage and getting to know each other, but working on the singing mostly.
And Heather, does it make you nervous acting in front of all those people?
No, not really. I like the stage. I'm really comfortable on it, and I just enjoy doing it, so it doesn't make me nervous anymore.
To both of you, have you gotten close with any of the other actors in the production?
Each other.
Yeah. And we're really close with Warbucks and Grace, too.
Just
we're good
almost
friends.
Everybody.
Yeah.
But we've earned a special relationship
right
together.
There are two basic ways to get involved in MCTV. One is to produce programs. The other is to work on these programs as part of a television crew. The first step to get involved in either one of these capacities is to register for one of our television production workshops. We offer two basic workshops. In one workshop, you learn to operate the television equipment here in the MCTV studio. In the other workshop, we teach you how to operate the portable equipment. Now, the workshop is a total of 8 hours of training. Here is our first scheduled workshops. These workshops are the studio production workshops. To register for a workshop, pick up a registration form here at the studio. This schedule will also be posted on MCTV periodically. Once you complete this workshop, you will be given an MCTV user card. This card will have your user number on it, and this will allow you to be put in our production pool. As programs are scheduled, we will call you to be a part of a crew for that show. If you want to produce programs, you need to pick up a program proposal. This form helps you finalize your ideas. Then you can make an appointment with someone here at MCTV so we can help you produce your first television program. MCTV is located at the west end of the Grace A. Dow Memorial Library. We are in the basement under the auditorium. There are two outside doors facing the west. This is our entrance. Now let me take you back to November so you can see how we started. Studio is located at the bottom of the stairway from that entrance. This basement was used for scenery and props and things when the library auditorium was used for productions. The desk, filing cabinet, and all the chairs were donated by Dow Chemical. We thank them for that. The basement also has dressing rooms and restrooms. These are still used when the library auditorium is being used. And this is the control room, before we had the walls put up. This is the studio as it is today, with a couple of offices, storage, and the control room. Let's take a look in the control room. This is Steve Lorla. He's a senior at Central Michigan University studying broadcasting. Steve's working here at MCTV as a college intern. Steve, how about queuing up your videotape for me? There are a lot of things that happen here at the library, and from time to time we'll try and cover these things. Here are two examples of what we might cover.
For the next few weeks, there will be more happening at the Grace A. Dow Memorial Library than the usual reading of books, magazines, and newspapers. Since January 16th, the Midland School District's elementary art classes have had on display a wide variety of works completed by 1st through 6th grade students. Here is a small sample of the art now on display. Art is a first in a series of exhibits to be displayed in the library. February, the Midland School District's junior high schools will be on display. March brings the work of senior high school art students to the library. The series will conclude with an all-school exhibit in the Midland Center for the Arts in April. This will feature artwork from all schools in the Midland School District and parochial schools. The Midland School District Elementary Art Exhibit is on display in the Mezzanine Gallery of the Grace A. Dow Library until February 6th. The exhibit can be seen during normal library hours.
Every Halloween, the Children's Library staff holds a story time and a trick-or-treating time for preschoolers. Last year, there was quite a turnout.
A lot of people have been asking if we will be doing sporting events. Unfortunately, no, we can't. We don't have the right equipment to do a basketball game or a football game. What we can do, though, or what you can do, is put together some highlights of a game. As an example, we went to the Midland Civic Arena to cover the Silver Stick Hockey Tournament. Here's what we did.
The 1985 International Silver Stick Hockey Regional Tournament was held in Midland on January 4th, 5th, and 6th in the Midland Civic Arena. This year's tournament was separated into six divisions, Pee-wee and Bantam B, Pee-wee and Bantam A, and Pee-wee and Bantam AA. The winners of each of the A and AA divisions will be invited to the North American Pee-wee and Bantam Silver Stick Finals to be held in Port Huron, Michigan on January 31st through February 3rd. There they will compete with representatives from the other 15 participating regions in the United States and Canada. We wish the Midland Regional winners the very best in the North American Finals.
Once you get involved in MCTV and you learn our equipment, you'll see that you can do a variety of things without having a computerized special effects generator. We put together a videotape that shows you a few things you can do with our equipment. Steve? We've answered most of your questions about MCTV. Of course, if you have any more questions, feel free to give us a call, or better yet, stop by the studio. We look forward to working with you on community programs.
We'll be right back.